Hello everyone, this is Anthony Keach with Academic Technology Services. And today we're going to take a look at Respondus Lockdown Browser and Respondus Monitor. We're going to look at what these tools can do, when they are appropriate to use, how to turn them on inside of D2L, and some tips and best practices that will help you to be successful. There are time codes in the video description below, so if you want to jump around to a particular section. Respondus Lockdown Browser is a web browser similar to Chrome, Firefox, Safari, or Microsoft Edge, except that it's designed to lock down the test environment, preventing a student from tabbing to other websites or having other programs open that may help them with their tests. By itself, this is helpful in a proctored environment, where a proctor or supervisor can ensure that students are not using material or technology that isn't attached to their primary computer, such as a mobile device or simply another person in the room. Respondus Monitor adds an extra layer and is designed for non-proctored settings, such as a student taking an exam remotely. Monitor uses a student's webcam to record them as they take their assessment, helping faculty to ensure that they are not using resources they should not be. These videos can be reviewed by the instructor after the exam. To enable Respondus Lockdown Browser and Monitor, log into D2L and access the assessment tool. Open the Lockdown Browser dashboard. If you have not used the dashboard before, you may be prompted with a short video to help you get started. Use the context menu to the left of any exam you already have created and select Settings. First, you will need to enable Lockdown Browser for the exam by selecting Require Respondus Lockdown Browser for this exam. Once that is enabled, you will be given the option to require Respondus Monitor, which is the recording piece for this exam. Select items in the startup sequence, which are the steps a student would take to being able to use Monitor before the exam. These are optional and apply to a unique exam, so you can set different sequence for different exams. You can preview each setting to get an idea of what it will look like for students, and some options allow you to edit the text presented. Once you have enabled all of your settings, select Save and Close. Now the exam requires both Lockdown Browser and Respondus Monitor. What this means for your students is that they will be able to start using the exam inside of D2L from any standard browser. Before the exam begins, they will go through the startup sequence steps that you enabled for your exam, including any specific instructions that you included. The webcam check is required every time they use Respondus Monitor to make sure that their webcam and microphone are working. Other checks like student photo or show ID are optional, but may help confirm the participant's identity. The environment check can be used to require students to record their surroundings to ensure no unauthorized resources, books, options, or other devices are present. After the startup sequence, the student will begin the exam. The recording will end when the student submits the exam. To review a recording, log into D2L, go to Assessments in the Respondus Lockdown dashboard, select the context menu to the left of an exam, and select Class Results. Expand a student's results by selecting a small plus sign next to their name. You can review the entire recording or jump to a specific thumbnail. Respondus uses analytics to trigger warnings and bring the focus of the instructor to a specific student or event. These warnings are not foolproof and may include false positives or record issues that the analytics miss. Monitor is intended as a deterrent. It's up to individual faculty members to determine the level of review warranted. To help students be successful, here are a few tips to consider. First, be patient and consider the complexity of what you're asking your students to do. Not only are they about to take an exam, which can be stressful by itself, now they're being asked to use a composite of different techniques which they may not have much experience with, as well as being recorded, which not everybody is comfortable with. Students may not have access to working webcams or microphones, so it is important to make your expectations and any requirements for the course clear. Finally, provide a low-stakes practice exam with unlimited attempts so that students can become familiar with the process.